For the diagnostic approach for patients with vascular anomalies, we always start with a clinical examination. As a good clinical examination will lead us to a preliminary diagnosis and will enable us to direct the further diagnostics. It also gives us a feeling about the complaints of the patient and how intensive the diagnostic and therapeutic approach must be. In many patients, the clinical examination is then followed up by ultrasound or sonography that gives us a good feeling about the extent of the disease into the tissue and also gives us information about any associated low flow or high flow anomalies. High flow anomalies mean that there's probably an arteriovenous component of the disease, and these need to be followed up more closely. Many patients with an extensive disease, a progressive disease, or associated complaints like pain need further evaluation. This is usually done by MRI, so magnetic resonance imaging, and can be done with and without angiography. The angiography allows us to see the vessels more clearly and then allows us to differentiate between lymphatic venous or arteriovenous malformations. This can be used to further stratify the treatment of the patients. Especially in patients with arteriovenous malformations, further workup can be necessary. This would be done by a catheter angiography, which gives us a much more detailed anatomy of the malformation and lets us identify the feeding vessels and the draining vessels. In a broader population of patients, we need to do blood tests like a blood count or coagulation status, since an extensive venous malformation can lead to pain and activation of the coagulation pathways. If we see a disruption of the coagulation pathway, especially with high D-dimers and low fibrinogen, we are able to initiate medical treatment which can alleviate pain and lessen the burden of thrombosis in these patients. In selected patients, a biopsy might be necessary. The biopsy helps us to evaluate differential diagnoses such as tumors. This is especially relevant in patients in which the diagnosis of a vascular malformation is not clear. In some cases, it also helps us to further stratify the underlying disease and the specific vascular malformation. From a biopsy sample, we also try to do genetic testing, which further helps us to identify the cause of the disease in the affected patients, but it also helps us to understand the diseases better. In some cases, the genetic testing will also open up new avenues of treatment, such as experimental medical treatment, such as with novel inhibitors.